Hi, viewers. I want to talk about something that I think is very confusing. And that is the symbols for vowel sounds in English. Now, I always use the International Phonetic Alphabet because that system was made so that it would represent every sound in all the languages in the world. And that way people from many places can agree on how they want to represent a speech sound. But if you look up pronunciation in some American dictionaries, or if you attend a class or you have a teacher or tutor that doesn't know about IPA, they may use some of these other symbols for English speech sounds. So I have put the list of the IPA vowels, and then across from each one, I have put different symbols that you could find in an American dictionary or maybe used by an instructor. Why did they decide to use these symbols? I think that they wanted to use letters of the alphabet, but there are 12 vowels in English, and there are only 5 letters in the alphabet. So they had to modify these letters to represent the additional sounds, vowel sounds, that we have in English. The only exception is here, schwa. Everyone agrees to use this symbol, which is not a letter of the alphabet, for schwa. And in spelling, we use one of the five vowel letters for schwa, even though, you know, it could be a different vowel letter. So let's look closely. Let's start up here. I'll read this pronunciation of these, each of these vowels. E, I, A, E, A, I, U, A, U, U, O, A, I, Ow, Oi. You see, these three are diphthongs and they have 2 vowel sounds. Okay, so when we look here at E, we see that the dictionaries and this system called phonics all use the same symbol for E. And in the English alphabet, we pronounce this letter E. So they call this long E. They put a long line on top of it. And that this is the IPA symbol. This is E. This symbol, however, is often used, the letter I, for the sound E in other languages. You'll also see that another long vowel, A, they also chose the pronunciation of the letter A to represent this IPA symbol. And they put a long line on top and it's called long A. The same is true for O. Everyone agrees. But here, this is I. Now, they've used a single I, and that's how we pronounce the letter I. But this is really 2 sounds, and it's a diphthong. That's a little confusing. So you can see that some of the sounds, like have several symbols for this IPA symbol. Same with ooh. Now, why do they use these phonics symbols? Phonics is not phonetics. They're two different things. Okay, this is phonics, it's a system, and this is phonetics. Phonics is a system that was created to help English-speaking children who can speak the vowel sounds and the sounds of English learn how to read. Because the sounds of English in speaking do not match very well with the spelling of English. And this can result in difficulty for children learning how to read. So this phonics was developed many years ago and is still in use. And in some of your classes, you may have teachers who use phonics. However, your native language is not English, and you may not have the English vowel sounds. In fact, you may have learned to learn English through reading, and so your problem may be just the reverse of an English-speaking child. You may not know how to pronounce the spelled word, but you know the spelled word. So it's backwards. I hope that this points out to you that they will use a long line, what they call a long vowel, and then they'll use this little symbol, what they call a short vowel. Also, sometimes they will use dots or little arrows above the vowel sound for their symbol. But I encourage you to learn the IPA because it's really the only way, if you're serious about learning to pronounce English, that you can identify the correct vowel sound. Thanks for watching, and thanks for learning English.